Hello guys, welcome to the channel. I'm Paul. We are still on the CityCap app and today I'll be talking about this authentication flow of it with bloc pattern. And for those of you that are new to the channel, if you have not subscribed to the channel, please click on the subscribe button, and also you can keep up with more of the videos I'll be posting by clicking on the notification button. So whatever thing I'll be uploading, you can see it fast and follow along. So here is what we'll be building. What we'll be building today is the outflow we'll be replicating from our designs here. I'll be adding more designs on every videos I'll be making. So just stay around. So today we'll be talking about the outflow of it. So, and it's going to be the phone number authentication with Firebase. So I would like you, before the start of this video, you should create an account and on Firebase. On our earlier videos, we have done that and connected it to Firebase. And on that, so here's our designs. So here, the user is going to give in its phone number, and from there we verify it with a 6-digit code that will be sent to the user, and from there it will count down and the user can impute the SMS code that will be sent to his phone number, and from there the user will be signed in. And that's what we'll be doing with Firebase, and I hope you're excited for this one. And here it is. So create your project on Firebase, go to authentication, okay, you get to sign in methods, you enable the phone authentication. So today we'll be doing it on Android, okay, some other day we'll do for the iOS platform, but today we'll be doing it for Android. So here is our project. Our project is opened. Project is open. Here are the dependencies you're going to add to your project. So you'll be able to do this. You're going to add the Firebase Core, the Cloud Firestore, the Firebase Auth, the Flutter blog, Equatable blog, and SMS autofill. So here is what I'm talking about, the autofill here. So that's what we're going to do also. So here I've created our project, and our project is nice and clean, and we have our lib folder, our assets here. So you help me and you add these assets to it. So you shouldn't worry about anything. You can just head over to the GitHub and report of this course and you can get everything. So you go, I hope you have installed this. You're going to get this. I'm going to click on Command X or Control S to get the packages, so to get all the packages. So now let's talk about services. So in our previous video we talked about our project folder structure. So we talked about pages, repositories, services, UI, and utils. And in our services is what does services for our users. So maybe perform tasks like as we have here, and perform the auth task, the auth service. Maybe from here we can add another service that opens a camera. So services here, I think it's what performs services for your users. So you can just do that, and I'll be creating the auth services here that manage our authentication flow for our users before we can go over to page and add our bloc pattern and everything. So that's what we'll be doing. So you should import this. I'll be explaining everything. You should import the Cloud Firestore and Firebase Auth, and That's the two things we'll be using, because as soon as we authenticate our user with the phone, we should be able to store his UID, his user ID, and also his phone number to our database for more verification and things like that. So you import these two packages, and also you create our services. I call it auth service, and I'm going to make it a singleton class, and this is it, a private constructor. And also I'm going to make this static instance we are utilizing the null safety, so everything here is null safe. So if you have not checked out the null safe, you can head over to flutter.dev and things like that. You can see them there. And also, if you're building your project with Flutter 2.2, you should be able to defaultly enable null safety to your project. So I'll be doing this, and also I'll be static auth service get instance. So we should be able to initialize this, and we are going to initialize this once. So if instance is null, we're going to initialize it, and we're going to do this Firebase auth and auth, and we're going to initialize this to this, and also we are going to add our complete. Here is our function that says verify phone send OTP. So this function is responsible for verifying a phone, and also it sends the one-time password code. And here is the function that says completed, and we have failed, so it will return Firebase auth exception. And also we have code sent to return the verification ID and the token ID. And also we have code auto retrieval timeout. And that is whenever the code is sent, that's what happened. You can just go over to, I think you should go over to Flutter Fire. And you're going to see authentication. Go to the this is it. So you can read about phone auth and everything about authentication on it. So I'm going to add the auth verify phone number, and what this does, you can over on it and see what it does. You can read through it, start the phone number verification process for the given phone number, and verification completed, we are going to pass this, and verification failed, we are going to pass this, and we could send to pass that and this. So we are done with the verification phone send OTP, and we are going to verify and login. So this will accept a verification ID, SMS code, and phone number. So that's what it will accept. And in our phone auth credential, we're going to pass in the verification ID and SMS code. So those are the things we're going to pass. And also in our auth credential, we're going to sign in with credential, and we're going to pass in this credential. So it will retrieve a user credential. So we're going to check if the auth credential, which is here, is not null. So if it is not null, we are going to run this code, and if it's not, we are going to return this because our future is returning a string. So I'm going to do this final UID, user ID, and I'm going to get the user ID, and also I'm going to call in Firestore instance collection users, and I'm going to add that. I'm going to shake to get the user ID here to see if it exists. So So I'm going to check that if this does not exist, I'm going to set this. I'm going to add a UID, the user UID, and also the user phone number, which is here. So if it is not, and that is that, and we have our second, our third method here that says get credential, and it will pass in phone auth credential, and here's the credential that you're going to send him, and it will return a user ID, to return a user ID as a string. So that is it for that. So I'm going to explain bloc pattern now, and that. So we are going to see what bloc does, and here is a little image that can explain a bit of it. And if you don't understand what I'm saying in this video, you can head over to the bloc library.dev and you see tons of documentations about it. So here is what bloc does. It takes a user event, an event, and it processes it, and it emits a state. So this is the process of everything. So we have the on events method, we have the transform events method, we have the map event to state method, we have the transform transition method, and the on transition method. So what we'll be using in this video for now, I think it will be the event, the map event to state, that map event to state is invoked with each event that is emitted by transform event, and is responsible for yielding state. So here is what we're using, and also you can check out the other events, like the on event is called as soon as an event has been added, and also the, and this is most likely to be the initial event, and we also have the transform events and things like that. So I have a little board here that I'll use to explain a bit of how bloc works. So if you know about stream, that's how bloc can take a chip. So we can have a stream sync here, and also we have a stream. So this could act as a stream pipe. Then we have our stream, so which act as a state, and also this acts as an event. I hope you understand what I'm trying to write here. And also this can also be called sync. This can be called sync, and also this also can be called streams. In this little pipe we have is where all these methods have been called. In our pipe here is where all this, so we have things like this and have like this. So in this method, the on event, event transform, map to event, map event to states, all of those functions are inside this pipe. So are all inside this pipe. So when a user might click a button, that's an event. Maybe a user wants to verify his number, and he clicks on event, it gets into this pipe and it's start processing it, and it emits a new state, phone number error, or some kind of states like that. Then from there you can change your UI accordingly to the state that is being emitted. So I hope you understand that. Let's get to our bloc. So I have our pages here, and I have our auth page. I'll close this and this. I have our auth page, authentication page, and I have created a bloc here. So to easily create a bloc, and to easily create a blog, you should go to extension and install this. So it's created by the one that is created by Felix Angelo. So should install this. I have done that, and here is the author of blog pattern, and you should check him out and that. So, and I've created my blog. You should just maybe right click on your odds, right click on it, go down, you see blog, new blog, click and create a name. Maybe yes, it, you add a name to your blog. So I've created mine and we call it odd blog, and I'll go over to our event. So our event is here. So we're creating different events that we'll use in our app. So currently here we have the event to verify our number, and as soon as we click it, it will take us to this page, and it will process, and from there it will emit the state of this to be resent, and from there we can get our code, and from there we can, because there will also be a button here, so when this is, this SMS code is being entered here, and you can click on this to verify you, so you can actually go in. So I have our hot event here. So I've created some events, and the first event is sign up event, though we are not going to use that, but here it is. It will be here. It will take all the values we'll provide here, the first name, last name, and email, things like that, to get all of them. And from there, we'll get the phone number verification event. Here, the event is from here. When we click on this, we should be able to get the number that is here. And so we can perform some process on it. We can perform some map to event state on it here. We can perform this on it. So that is that. And also we have the phone auth code verification verified event, and this will be the phone, the SMS code, and the verification code. And also have the completed auth event. This will take our auth credential and credentials. And also we have the error occurred event to take the error. All of them should be able to be passed in here. So we are actually creating them because of this. So the phone is this, the completed, failed, code sent, and things like that. And I'm going to add this, the code sent event that takes verification ID and token. So token ID. So that's all of it. We'll go to our auth state, and I'm going to explain the state those events are going to be emitting. And the first of it will be the initial state. So whenever you come into our app, you're going to see the initial state of our app, and nothing should happen on the initial state of our app. And you're going to see the loading state. The loading state is maybe when we click here, maybe we want a spinner, then, and that would be a state to change our UI. And also we have a logged in state, and this is when our user is logged in. We are going to get his UID and that, though this will not be like this. We are going to update this, but for the sake of this video, to explain it and so you understand, this is going to be our logged in user state. Whenever our user is logged in, should be able to get his UID, his user ID, and display it on our screen. And also we have the auto logged in state that extends the logged in state. So this is it. It logs, it extends this. So if you know about inheritance, here is what happens on this part. It inherits from the auth state, and from here it inherits from the logged in state. So, and that is that. And also we have the state error sign up. The state error sign up takes whenever we an error occurred, we should be able to get a message for that. And also we have the code sent state. Whenever a code is sent, should be able to get the verification ID and also the token. And that is it. So the token is responsible whenever maybe want to resend a code. Maybe we didn't get the code we want to resend, that the token will be using to resend that code. And that is it. So we'll go over to our blog, and here is our blog. I've made all the imports already. They are all in the repository. Should go and see how it is, and maybe if you see any issues, things you don't, it that doesn't seem right, you should create an issue, or you talk about it on the comment section of this video. And in the start of this, we have the map event to state. So here it is map event to state, and it's invoked with each event that is emitted by transform event, and it's responsible for yielding state. So it's return states in streams. You don't call it return, you call it yield. And for you to yield, you have to use this async star, and it's responsible for the yield keywords. So and our initials block is going to be initial state. So here it is in our state. And also we are going to have the if event is phone number verification event, and also we have the if event is phone code verified. So whenever here it will be this event, and the second will be this event. And also we have event is code sent whenever event has been sent from the auth service, then it is sent. So that is it. And also we can be able to yield the code sent state with the event verification ID and token that we have passed, and also the logged in. You should be able to get this from the auth service, verify and login. So we'll get the event from the phone auth code verified event, and we'll get the SMS code, the phone number and the verification ID, and it will return us our UID, and we'll pass it in our logged in state. And also we'll create phone auth verification to state, and here it is. It's going to return auth states as a stream. And also the first thing we're going to use, loading auth states. And the next we're going to add is verified phone send OTP. So here is where does all the magic that you see. So whenever our phone is passed in and our phone number is passed in, it goes ahead trying to verify, and all of that is being done for you by the Firebase and phone auth API. So you don't need to do all of that yourself, and it will add the completed auth event with the credential here. And we have the field method that has error in it, so we are going to add the error occurred event, and we are going to pass that to string. And also we have the code sent, we have the code sent event, so we can go through all of this yourself. And also we have the code auto retriever timeout. We are going to add this as well. So that is it, and that is it for it. So I'm going to go in our UI now. So I have my emulator ready here. So yeah, I have my Android emulator ready. It's real device. So, and we'll go over to our UI now. So in our first UI, we have the theme. We have our theme and we have extension. I've talked about extension before. You can go over to my previous videos on extension and see what extension does. And I have extension on widgets, and it will have extension using the padding. So I don't want every time I'll be calling the padding, because padding is actually extension for our app. The size is very essential for our app. So I don't want to always be calling that maybe as a class, but just with the dot syntax I can get and wrap it on our widgets, whatever widget we have. And we have the city theme. I've created this theme, we'll add more of it. And I have the static element spacing to be 16, and the city, our blue color, I call it city blue. This is the blue and the white, and I've created a theme, and here it is. So I also have in our utils that I have added this in our image assets, so we can easily call it. And so we have added this already here. I hope you have done that. So I'll close this. I'll save this and close. I'll save this, close, close, and close. So in our main, if you haven't seen our main, here's our main. We have the main entry that actually is responsible of running our program. And I have our auth block, and I've added it, initialize it, and I'm using the let keyword for this to initialize it. And I'm using the block provider here. So I should actually call our dispose method, so it can dispose this whenever we don't want it. Block.close. Cool. And in our material app, the title city cab and theme, and we have our home. So city theme is from the theme here, and that we have our home here. So we'll go back to the home, but with that, let's go to our widgets. Our phone text field that I've created already, so it's takes a focus and perform some focus on it, so we can actually change according to whatever focus we have when our keyboard is focused or not. So where it really happens is on the prefix and the prefix icon. So you can go over to check that, and what happens there is if it is focused, it should come up with this flag. We are going to edit that in the future, so you don't have so much worry about it. So here is everything, except text field, and I've made some configurations here that you should check out. And in our home here, we have home page. In our home page here, we should be able to edit this in the future. It's just for odd episodes, so we don't have to do much. Here in our odd page, it's where the interesting part comes in. So we have some few things here I'll be explaining, because I've done it already. I'll be explaining how I did it. So I have a page controller here that we're using, we are using a push controller. So like this, it should, maybe you click, it swipe to the next, and that is it. So that's what we're using. And we have our phone, our text editing controllers, and also we have our OTP controller that's responsible of the text fields and to store our text fields. And also we have our screen size, so we can actually get our screen size and sizes like that. And also we have our block consumer here. So if you should go to the block state management here, you can be able to read about block consumers if you get a chance to do that. So in our block consumer here, you should be able to read this. It exposes builder and listener in order to react to state changes. So here in our listener, when our state that will pass here is logged in, you should be able to animate to our second page, which is the sign up page, and that is where our user ID is going to display. And also our builder, which is here. And don't forget to pass in the block. I'm using context.wash or block because we have already created that on our block provider, and we have created that already, so we don't have to recreate it. And we are printing the state. So why are we not using just block builder? It's because if we should check and the state is logged in and we are passing it in this builder state, it will be bad for us and it will cause a lot of problem. So the listener is only called once and the builder is called more than once. So you should use the listener. And to use just the listener, I think you can just use block listener to do that. And here is our code. And for here, and here we have the build float action button. So it's this, is that, and we have a position because we are actually using a stack here. So we have a position, we have a position to be bottom 0 and right 0, and we are able to give the padding here to be 16 so that it will be visible. And also in our floating action button here, we have our background color to be gray and our blue. So if the state is loading, we should change the color to gray, and if it is not loading, it should be the city blue. It should be the city blue. And the icon is arrow forward iOS. And in our onPress, now onPress method here, when the state is out state, it should return null. Nothing should happen. Clicking on it should not pass in any events. And if it is not loading state, it should call on this. So, and we have some if statements here. And our first if statement is phone controller, and we are trying to call to get the text in our phone controller. So if it is, it's not empty and the state is initial state, we should be able to run this. And in our blog block provider here, we are adding this event. So here's the event. When we add it in our block, it should be able to map it to whatever state we want. And as soon as we add that, we're going to animate to the second page, and in the duration of 400, and we are using the curve of is in. So let me close that. I hope you're seeing this well. And in our if else if we have if state is good send state, we should be able to add the phone auth verified event. So we're going to pass in our OTP text and also the verification ID and also our phone number from the phone controller. And we have our views here, which are pages in our page view. So the first one we are going to look at is the phone page. So it's here in the widgets. All of this code is ready on the GitHub. You should check it out. And that is it. And in the phone page, what we have is the image, and I'm using the aspect ratio of 1, and we have called on the image, the card image, which is this, and also we'll have the text field, so which is this, and that's it. And we're going to pass in the number controller that we passed from the auth page here, the phone controller, and I'm going to pass it in here and in the text field. So that's it for the phone page. And we have our OTP page. So in our OTP page, we have our text editing controller to be passed in here, our auth block, our phone number. So the phone number that is entered should be passed in here. And also we now have the block consumer. So if code is sent, it should start this countdown, and the countdown is what counts here. So just start this countdown, and if it is above 30, we are using the timer.periodic. If it is above 30, we should be able to cancel this timer. And here we have the text code, the enter code, which is this, all of that. And we have the text. We have a 6-digit code that's been sent to table number that will pass in phone number. And here is the pin field auto fill. So you should be able to get that on pop-up dev. You can get it here. And we passed in the OTP controller, and we're able to edit all of this, and you should check it out. And we give spacer, and if state is loading, we should print and display verifying. If not, we should shrink it with size box. And if state is good send, we should start seeing the countdown. And that's all for it. That's all for it. And I think I'm going to run this. I'm going to run all of this to see if everything works fine. So I'm going to save and click on our F5. So this is running. And to add to this, you should be able to do this yourself. Should be able to do this yourself. And if you have any questions, I'm totally open for your questions, and to drop it on the comments section of this video. And it's loading, it's installing, should be able to see it in no time. So this actually works on your Spark plan. So, but it has some limitations, maybe 50 a day, so you don't have to do it more than 50 a day. So it's loading. So here it is. So everything looks nice and clean, and clicking on it and it focuses, it changes to the country code. You should be able to edit that yourself. So I'm going to impute my number, and here it is. I'm going to click OK here, and to click on the floating action button here, click on it, and it takes me to the next page and saying verifying, and this has been disabled, and it will take me out of the app to verify if I'm a robot or not, and it's verifying to check if I'm not a robot. So, and it has been initialized, the code has been sent, so I'm waiting for it in 30 seconds. So the default time is 30 seconds, so we are waiting for it. Okay, here's the code. I'll copy it and I'm going to add it here. Let's see our console. In our console, you see all the messages that you want to see. So it's notifying for a new user that has been created, and here is my user ID. So thank you so much for watching this video. I'm having the plans of reaching 2,000 subscribers this year, so you can get me to that point. Please subscribe to this channel and also like this video. And if you have any challenges on these particular videos, I'm open for whatever you want to ask. And also, if what I'm explaining is wrong, and please, you can just correct me. I'm still learning Flutter and happy coding. Thank you.